Well guys, here is our crankshaft with our old piston, old connecting rod, old bearings, and all the pieces and pins and all that. Now to replace all this stuff, you have to split the webs apart from the pin.
So as you can see from our mess, we are doing some modifications to the Diecycle. Right now, we are working on this little guy that I built. So this is the master cylinder for the rear. I have it mounted kind of in this orientation, kind of sideways. And it goes up and goes to the caliper. But I made this little piece that bolts onto there with these little ears so it doesn't try to wobble on us. And it goes down to this footrest piece and this arm mechanism that's our pedal. Now, it's just in prototype form. As you can see, I've been drawing on it. But this piece here is gonna be kind of like our footrest. And then when you tip your foot forward, that's when you'll actuate the brake.
A quick fast forward. I refined the design down to these templates so we can go ahead and start transferring this and turning it into metal. Our sacrificial table to cut out our patterns for our brake, and we have a rough diagram drawn out. This is going to be finalized later, so let's go ahead and get this cut out.
Buds thinks she can fabricate too. What's up, little one? Say hi to the camera. Aw, oh, she's saying hi. Stretch the belly.
Alrighty guys, here's our first piece cut out. Now we don't have it finalized, but this is our basic shape. Pretty thick stuff.
Took a little bit, but we got it cut out of metal. This is just the pedal piece, and this piece here, this linkage, it came from a samurai sword. It sacrificed its life to become a brake lever piece, but and because of the extra weight, I had to add the spring, but no big deal. So we're just waiting on a piece that'll help us bend this and make it nice and straight. So let's get that all done up. Well, here is our brake pedal. It's a little rough because I've been trying to fit it and sculpt it and get it to work, but so we tried cutting the crankshaft in half, and it worked, except my cutoff wheel wouldn't go far enough in to cut all the way through. So I broke down and bought me a big old plate of steel, and we're gonna make a notch, slide it in there, and split it.
Well, guess what we have successfully split in half? But these are our old pieces, so let's get our new ones there. And there we go. So we're gonna put that together. We got one side pressed in. Now you can kind of see how it all goes together. And just like that, we have a working crankshaft, just like it's supposed to be. So if you're going to do crankshaft work yourself, which I did not realize I was actually stumbling upon, you have to buy a shop press, and you have to make one of these really thick bastards.